Hi, my name is Roland Emmerich, and you'll watch now my career in 4 minutes. I was actually hired to do a Stallone movie, which I quit after 9 months because I didn't like the script. But the financier of this film was so taken by my decision to say no to the likes of Joel Silver and Sylvester Stallone that he offered me this smaller movie, which was great for me because it's good to kind of not start really big. It was like under 20 million. It was, just super fun. I had all the freedom in the world, you know, and I have very, very good memories of that. Mario Casar from Carolco told me, I said, who's in this film? And they said, it's Dolph Lundgren and Jean-Claude Van Damme. I said, I think I know Dolph. He was like kind of in the boxer who had to fight Stallone, but I had no idea who was Jean-Claude Van Damme. Most people, when I wanted to do a science fiction movie, they said, well, science fiction movies don't work in Hollywood. And I said, what about Star Wars and Star Trek? And they said, oh, that's something different altogether. I said, what is different about that, you know? And so there was this whole thing, there was a slew of science fiction movies which didn't work, which immediately lets everybody believe, you know, there is no future in science fiction, which I kind of thought that's silly. And I had this idea in film school, and I just waited for the moment somebody will give me money for it. You know, at one point, you know, the company actually who produced it sold the TV rights to MGM, and they actually came to us and offered Dean and me to do the TV show. But I think we thought the money per episode was too little to get quality, which is right for us, so we're like kind of we're not involved in that. Well, it was a defining moment for me, you know, because it was one of these things where a lot of people in the business said, you know what, Roland, this will only come once in your lifetime, and they were right, you know, because it's the first like mega hit, and then you're like all of a sudden people take you all of a sudden serious, and wherever you go there, people say, oh, this is Roland Emmerich, and that changed kind of quite a bit my life, and but I always like kind of say, you know, I'm a filmmaker, I want to kind of make other films, and now I'm like kind of trying to do a sequel. That would be interesting. I only lately watched a bit of it, and it's a much better movie than what people think it is. Also, I think I meet a lot of kids who were then kids, you know, who were like 7, 8, 9, or 11 or 12, which are now 25 or 28. They have a totally different conception of this film. It's actually my favorite movie ever made. It was like a hard and long journey to make that movie. I had to put some guns to some people's heads, so they let me do this. And you know what, it's one of these things, you know, it's sometimes, I understand when somebody like Bill Murray is like kind of conceived as a comedian, but he actually also wants to do traumatic work, and they don't let him. And then he has the first one, he's like the traumatic, and they make like a joke out of him. But he is persistent. He says, I don't care, I want to play serious parts. And all of a sudden now we don't conceive like Bill Murray as a comedic actor anymore. We just conceive him as an actor, you know, which is a great thing. And I hope this will happen to me too. Well, that was exactly what interested me about this film. It's just something which I haven't done before. A hostage drama, it was a buddy movie, it had all these like elements. And actually, you know what, I have to say, you know, if you have the chance to do a movie with Channing Tatum and Jamie Foxx, I mean, you must be blessed. And I'm blessed that I even know these guys, because they're just great.